In this two-part demo, we'll write a MATLAB code to plot a projectile's velocity using the built-in Heaviside function. This demo assumes basic competency with the Heaviside function and the unit step function in general. Here's the velocity of a projectile from 0 to 16 seconds. It is a piecewise function consisting of two segments, one from 0 to 8 seconds, and one from 8 to 16 seconds. We want to compute v of t given this t vector using MATLAB's Heaviside function. The first thing we should do is guess what v of t looks like qualitatively. V of t is comprised of two components which I'll call v1 and v2. v1 is parabolic and v2 is linear with a negative slope, so we should expect the graph to look something like this. This is obviously a crude sketch, but a quick qualitative analysis will help you check your code later on. Here's the flowchart of the problem. The flowchart's simplicity is reflective of the problem's straightforward nature. Even though we probably don't need to make a flowchart for this problem, it's a good habit to build. We're using a vectorized built-in function, so there's no need for a loop or if statements. I decided to control when v1 and v2 turn on or off with the Heaviside function. This is a good segue into discussing the Heaviside step function. As you know, the Heaviside function, also sometimes called the unit step function, is 0 when t is less than 0 and 1 when t is greater than or equal to 0. We can generalize this by saying the unit step function is 0 before some switching point b and 1 on and after that switching point b. This switching point can be anywhere we want, not just at t equals 0. This top graph shows the unit step function, and this bottom graph shows what we call the shifted Heaviside step function. In this particular case, we chose the shift to occur at t equals 1 second. There's a clever use for the step function. We can use it to control when parts of the piecewise function turn on and off. Take v1 for example. v1 turns on at 0 and off at 8. If we multiply v1 by 0, we get 0 and the function is considered off. If we multiply v1 by 1, we just get v1 and it is considered to be on. Well, the Heaviside function is very conveniently either 0 or 1, so we just need to finagle with the switching point to control whether it turns the function on or off. So we can write v of t as the sum of v1 times some Heaviside function and v2 times some other Heaviside function. This type of usage is incredibly common in your higher level classes, particularly controls. You should always read a built-in function's documentation, even if you already know how to use it. You could relearn something or find another implementation. I've linked the Heaviside documentation in the description. If you read carefully, you'll spot a slight formulaic discrepancy between this video and the documentation. It doesn't matter because this function is piecewise continuous, but you should be aware of it. In the next video, we'll crank up MATLAB and code this.